So, if you know, you know. IS-300, first generation. Apparently, well, not apparently, but it is a very common thing, except for it happened to me finally. I got to replace the booster. So, we're going to do that today. So, I'm going to show you what you need to do. My favorite part after doing all of this. We always know which one we're going to grab. And like any job I do, the first step is always get the music playing, baby. Without music, life is just too boring. We can start off with some Post Malone. The second step, relax. Unplug this, undo this, and when we get to the bolts inside the car, we're gonna get this. You won't see it, but you're gonna want that one and that one right there. And we're gonna leave everything without opening the system, and we're just gonna, as best as we can, just, you're gonna want to take this off. So you got a screw here, you got a screw here, and you got one hidden right here. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. And then there's a few plugs underneath, and it should be pretty easy. We've got it off, so you can see what I see. I got a air temperature sensor tube, a air temperature sensor plug. Mine doesn't have anything here, so it only had this one here. And then the only two things left looks like the hood latch cable and the ECU diagnostic plug port. That one is easy to reach. The top corner one, top right, bottom left are easy. This one is not a straight shot, as you can see. So you have to go around this way. And then the hardest one was the top left-hand corner, because you have to move this computer, and you got a harness in the way and some other things in the way. But if you can get there, it's the hardest one. So I cut my finger in, but part of the job. Your booster out, you want to check it out. Looks pretty good. I seen a thin one. This one's nice and thick. Looks nice and thick. And you know, you want to look that this isn't sticking out or in too much. So it looks pretty even. It's just the tip. And so we are going to have to remove this and put it onto this, and then basically just take a measuring tape and measure from here to here, and you'll be able to match that exact specification on your new one from here to here. You're gonna want to, in a perfect world, either get new one of these or try to reuse the one that is on there. You know, it's a small detail, even I forgot about it. So I am going to try to make a new one for myself. So it's a 14 millimeter for this. It's not too hard. Just grab a pair of channel locks or something, or a vise to grab this end. And then just, it wasn't super hard. And it just comes loose. And then you'll be able to undo this one and put it on this one. So before I do that, I'm going to make a measurement and then be able to do the same thing on this side. All right. Report back. Problem is fixed. And really, other than the unit being upside down and having to figure that out, as you can see, the line is no longer from here to here. It's from here to here.